Hello, it's Keith here, and this is the 8th in the platform-specific series of my 650 to assembly programming tutorials. We've been doing various systems over the last few weeks, doing bitmap graphics on each. We're going to do the VIC-20 this week. Now, the VIC-20 is a bit different to the other systems we've covered. It doesn't use a bitmap display because of its limited memory, and it also technically doesn't use a tile map. What it uses is a fixed character set. Now, this character set is in ROM, but we can move it to RAM. And what we can do is we can define our own characters and use those to simulate bitmaps. Effectively, we're using the characters as a tile map. So I'm calling it characters, not tiles, but in effect, it's basically the same. And I use this in the same way as the tile map in my Grime 6502 game to make the game work on the VIC-20, and it worked quite nicely. So today we're going to learn how to set up the screen display, how to define the characters, and how to get those characters onto the screen. So let's make a start and have a look today. Now, the VIC-20 unfortunately doesn't use ASCII by default. So the character map as it appears in ROM, you can see just here. So character 0 is actually the at symbol, and then they go along here. Now, in my tutorial code, I'm actually converting ASCII to the correct character codes by remapping the various ranges that are wrong just for the A to Z and 0 to 9. You'll also notice there's no lowercase. In the cases of all of the other tutorials, I'm actually using a bitmap font. So we've got a common appearance on all the systems. But on the VIC-20, I haven't done that, and the reason for that is that the memory is very limited. I believe there's only 4K of memory on the basic VIC-20, although one easy way around that is to use cartridge ROMs, and then we can have our game in ROM, and then we can just use the RAM for the graphics and the program data, and we can use the ROM for our program code. So that's one option. Now, when it comes to setting up the screen, the memory of the screen is by default at hexadecimal 1E00. We're going to set the character data up to be at 1C00, and this will allocate enough space for 64 tiles. We can up that to 128 tiles by relocating the screen to hexadecimal 1000, but we're not going to actually look at that today. When we remap the characters and have our custom characters will be from 0 to 127, and the 0 to 127 default characters will be pushed up into the next 128. So when we're using that custom character map, we're going to have to remap our characters if we want to show the normal A to Z with the internal ROM font. So let's have a look at the code we're going to be running today. So first of all, let's run the code and see what it actually looks like on screen. So this is running from a ROM file. We can run it as a PRG file as well. The difference is only slightly in the header. The main problem with running as a ROM file is the system doesn't do any kind of boot up and do any screen setup for us. So it's harder to run from a ROM file. And if we can run from a ROM file, we can just use the same code on a program file because we're obviously doing everything just fine. And there are compile options in my tutorial code if you get the dev tools from my website for both versions. So you can see here we've got Hello World and we've got the monitor dump here. And these are using the ROM font, not the custom font as we do on the other systems. And then here we've got the Chibico character just here. So you can see here we've been able to draw our Chibico character. Of course, this is now using custom characters, and these custom characters have been defined as a 2-bit bitmap, and we've got our ROM font here. We'll just exit that. And just to show you, that was the ROM version, but if I use the RAM version here, this will run as a program, and you can see the result is exactly the same. There we go. Now, when it comes to treating this VIC-20, we're actually treating it as a tile-based system because effectively that's the way we're doing things. We're defining the custom characters and then we're getting the custom characters onto the screen to allow us to show a bitmap. So you can see here, just as before, we're loading in the bitmap data. And if you want to export a file in VIC-20 format, you can use this Save Raw Bitmap option here on the VIC-20 page of my AccuSprite editor here. So you can see, as with all of the tutorials, we can export the bitmap into the format for today's example. So that's what I'd suggest you do if you want to create your own bitmaps. Now, when it comes to actually loading in, the destination is a memory address, and so we're loading into hexadecimal 1C00 here, and that's the address we're going to define for the custom characters. We then run the define tiles command, which copies the data into that address. The size of the data is in the 0 page BC here, and the source of the data is in the 0 page HL here. Once we've defined the custom characters, we show them to the screen with the fill area of the tiles command. On all the other systems, we're using tile 128 onwards, but on the VIC-20, we're using character 0 onwards, because remember, I said that when we use a custom character set at 1C00, the real characters, the internal ROM ones, move up to 128. So that's why we're using a different number there. But apart from that, this code is identical. Of course, all of the magic is being done within this VDP memory function, which is a mirror image for the ones for the Super Nintendo and systems like that. So first of all, we need to set up the screen. There's a lot of options that we need to set up, and these appear at memory address 9000 onwards. Now you can see here, there's a variety of registers here, and I've put the suggested settings just here, and also some alternate settings for if you want to relocate the screen memory. This will allow you to have up to 128 custom characters, but it will mean that you will have less memory available, and it's probably only going to be good enough for you if you're running from a ROM cartridge. So, generally speaking, I wouldn't suggest changing these settings. You can use them to relocate the screen or make the screen wider or taller, but there are some limitations on that. And of course, it does use more memory if you do that, so it is going to pose potentially other problems for you. Anyway, we're going to be leaving most of these settings the same today, so let's have a look at the code once again. So we're copying all of these consecutively to hexadecimal 9000, and of course, there's 16 in total. So the first one's the horizontal centering, the second one's the vertical centering. Now, this one shares some bits. Most of them are the number of columns, but the top bit is part of the screen address of the base of the screen memory. And then we've got a number of rows in here, and we've got one here. I can't honestly say I know what this one does. I guess this is to do with maybe the refreshing of the screen once it's completed drawing the screen. Then we've got some more of the screen memory. Again, this is one you will want to change if you want to relocate the screen to hexadecimal 1000. Bits 4 to 7 define the address of the screen memory. Bits 0 to 3 define the character memory and those customer characters. Now, there are only a few options that we can select when we want to show the custom characters, and depending on the bit combination we have, the memory will be mapped into RAM or ROM as shown here. The next one you're really going to want to see is this one here. Now, this is relating to the screen and border color, and so what we're doing is we're setting the background to blue here. Now, there are some limitations on what colour options you can have for the background. So at the moment we're using blue, but we will see some other examples later on for changing the colour. So this is how we're getting our screen set up. And this is, of course, run at the start of our program. Now, we saw that define tiles command, and what that was doing is it was copying the bitmap data into the character definitions. Well, it's very straightforward. All we're doing is we're jumping to an LDIR command. Now, if you're familiar with Z80, LDIR is a command for copying a bank of memory. And you can see here, effectively, what I've done is I've created a simulation of LDIR. We're copying BC bytes, with BC being defined in the zero page, from HL in the zero page to DE in the zero page. We're using indirect references here, so zero page entries HL and DE are addresses, and BC is a count of bytes. So this is copying that data into the character map, and that's all we need to do to get our Chibico character defined in the character map, and then we can show it to the screen. And that's done by this fill area with tiles command. Now this will show a bitmap at B, C in X, Y coordinates, and it will be width X and height Y. We use the get VDP screen pos command to calculate the memory position of the character that we want to change. Now we can see this up here, we'll have a look at it in just a moment, but once we've got that character position, effectively all we do is we store the first character number specified, which will of course be 0, into the address HL, which will be calculated by the VDP screen pos command. We then proceed to ink HL, the destination address, add one to the accumulator, which is the tile number, and we loop around until we get to the end of the line. Once we've done a line, we then calculate the next screen line. We loop back up to here, recalculate the screen line, and repeat until we've completed the entire Chibico character. So that's how we're doing things here. Now, I should point out that the VIC-20 is capable of colours. We can have attribute colours in the same way as a system like the Spectrum. Now, we're going to look at that in a later lesson, so I'm not going to cover that just today. But you can see here, GRIME 6502 does do colours. And, of course, GRIME 6502 is free and open source, so you're welcome to download it if you want to, and you can rush ahead and look at how the colours work. But we're going to do that very shortly anyway. So you can see there that colours are perfectly possible on the VIC-20. We're just not going to cover them in this bitmap lesson. So that's the procedure we run, but of course, how do we get that visual screen pos? Well, it's pretty straightforward. The way we've defined the screen, and this is of course relating to this bit byte here and this byte here, is we've defined it at 1E00. So that's the start of our screen. Now, the way we've defined the screen, it's also 22 tiles wide, or 22 characters wide, sorry. So if we want to calculate a line, our formula would be Y position times 22 plus X position plus screen base, and screen base is 1E00. So this is what we're going to do here. We're doing it fairly crudely. I'll be honest, I haven't really tried that hard to optimize this version because the mathematics is a bit odd and the screen's so small, it didn't really feel worth it. So what we're doing here is we're loading H with the base, which is 1E. We don't need to load the 00, of course. We're then loading ZL, the zero page L value, with the zero page B value, which is our X position. Then what we're doing is we're loading DE with hexadecimal 22. That's a pair, but we're loading with just 22. And we're loading Y with the counter of the number of Y lines. And then we're effecting a multiply by repeatedly adding DE to HL. So we're then calculating the offset for the Y position. Once we've done that, we've now calculated the line for the character we want to show. As I say, that's not that efficient. And some of the others we've been doing a bit shift effecting a multiply. But with this one, because it was quite odd number with 22, it didn't really divide very well in binary. And I thought that being as the system was, you know, had a relatively fast processor and a very small screen, it didn't really feel worth the optimization time. So I kind of slacked off a little bit there. But that's how we can get our bitmap to the screen. And that's really all there is to it. It's very straightforward, really. So we'll just see that again. And of course, if you want to do a different kind of character, you can do so. The Grime 6502 graphics were all done with my Acro Sprite editor. And so that's really all there is to the VIC-20. We're going to be looking at the Commodore 64 next time. And of course, we're going to come back to the VIC-20 when we start to do colors and sounds and joystick control later on. I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. If you have, please share it on social networks, because that really helps a lot of new people find my tutorials. And it's really a big boost for me, encouragement-wise, to keep making these tutorials. So anyway, thanks for watching today, and goodbye.